You're on the Melbourne City Council, so it's good that you're here.
Thank you, Joseph. I thought you were going to offer to hold the baby, but... look, can I begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land we're on today, the Kulin Nations, and pay my respect to their elders both. Auntie Caroline for her very warm welcome to country, and Sharon and Robbie as well. I would also like to acknowledge the work that Councillor Oak has done in relation to this cause. Joseph's right when he says that the Indigenous or the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander portfolio comes under my area at Council, but Councillor Oak has been really passionate about this particular cause and has made sure that that hasn't slipped in any of the other things that we've been doing at Council. We have just in the last 12 months done our Reconciliation Action Plan, which was the first time the Reconciliation Action Plan was actually voted on and passed unanimously by all councillors. And one of the really important parts of that Reconciliation Action Plan was that we're going to fly the Aboriginal flag at Town Hall. It's a wonderful recognition of the role and the rights of Aboriginal people in this country, and I'm very proud of that achievement. I am too looking forward to the May meeting when we're going to be looking at Indigenous and heritage in Melbourne, and in particular we'll be looking at this site and what we can do here. I particularly wanted to come along this afternoon to say that I wanted you to know that this has my support as well, and in seeing Councillor Watts and Councillor Oak here today, I think we've got a good body of support for getting this memorial up. I think that someone's telling me that I've spoken long enough, so thank you very much, and yes, I hope to see that this commemoration. At 1 year, maybe next year or the year after, we'll have a permanent memorial here. Thanks very much.